Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Monday, the Feast of the Conversion of St. Paul the Apostle. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. I know the one in whom I have believed, and I am sure that he, the just judge, the mighty, will keep safe what is my due until that day.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate the Feast of the Conversion of St. Paul the Apostle, we also wish to remember at this Mass, President Cory Aquino. Today is also her birth anniversary. So please, we offer also prayers for her and prayers for our country. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who taught the whole world through the preaching of the blessed Apostle Paul, draw us, we pray, nearer to you through the example of him whose conversion we celebrate today, and so make us witnesses to your truth in the world. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul addressed the people in these words, "I am a Jew, born in Tarsus of Cilicia, but brought up in this city. At the feet of Gamaliel, I was educated strictly in our ancestral law and was zealous for God, just as all of you are today. I persecuted this way to death, binding both men and women and delivering them to prison. Even the high priest and the whole council of elders can testify on my behalf. For from them I even received letters to the brothers and set out for Damascus to bring back to Jerusalem in chains for punishment those there as well. On that journey, as I drew near to Damascus, about noon, a great light from the sky suddenly shone around me. I fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to me, 'Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?' I replied, 'Who are you, sir?' And he said to me, 'I am Jesus, the Nazarene, whom you are persecuting.' My companions saw the light, but did not hear the voice of the one who spoke to me. I asked, 'What shall I do, sir?' The Lord answered me, 'Get up and go into Damascus, and there you'll be told about everything appointed for you to do.' Since I could see nothing because of the brightness of that light, I was led by hand by my companions and entered Damascus. A certain Ananias, a devout observer of the law, and highly spoken of by all the Jews who lived there, came to me and stood there and said, 'Saul, my brother, regain your sight.' And at that very moment, I regained my sight and saw him. Then he said, 'The God of our ancestors designated you to know his will, to see the righteous one, and to hear the sound of his voice. for you will be his witness before all to what you have seen and heard. Now why delay? Get up and have yourselves baptized and your sins washed away, calling upon his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify him, all you peoples.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
For steadfast is his kindness toward us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Alleluia, alleluia. I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus appeared to the 11 and said to them, go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, I always look at the conversion of St. Paul as a big feast of the church. No? Remember, Paul was one of the great evangelizers. In fact, if there were two great evangelizers that we would sort of consider, it is really Peter and Paul, no? the almost like the twin towers or the twin pillars of the church. No? And in our readings for today, there is a very interesting, you might say, dynamics or process of conversion. Pag pinagnilaya natin yung ating mga pagbasa ngayong araw, makikita natin ano ang galaw, ano ang biyaya ng conversion o ang pagbabalik loob sa Diyos. No? Una sa lahat, makikita natin na ang pagbabalik loob ay isang personal at isang interior na encounter sa Panginoon. Kagaya ng unang pagbasa, nagkaroon ng personal encounter si San Pablo sa ating Panginoon sa risen Lord actually, no? And remember that is one of the in quotes the qualifications of apostle, that one has encountered the risen Lord. And here Paul has that deep interior experience. In fact, you will notice in the reading, sabi doon na hindi nila nakita, no? Hindi nila, okay, babasahin ko yung lugar na yon, ano, na hindi nila nakita yung mga kasama niya. My companions saw the light but did not hear the voice of the one who spoke to me. So nakita nila yung liwanag pero hindi nila nakita ang Panginoon at hindi nila narinig yung sinabi ng Panginoon kay San Pablo, no? Kaya napakalalim na deep spiritual experience ito. Pero ang maganda rin na dapat nating makita, dahil makikita natin sa Ebanghelyo na mula sa personal experience of conversion, nagbubunga ito sa gawa. Nagbubunga ito sa pagsasagawa ng misyon ng Panginoon. At yun ay binigay sa atin sa Ebanghelyo. So maybe that first point to reflect on, that spiritual deep conversion must bear fruit in missionary work. I think that's very important. We saw that in Paul. And the second story I'd like to share for conversion, also to honor her on her birthday, is the story of President Cory. Remember, all throughout her life, she was at the background. No? She never wanted to involve herself in politics, although her family, you need to remember, was a very political family, both the Kawangko side and also the Sumulong side. Her mother was a Sumulong. No? And yet, she chose to become really at the background, no? To serve her family, to serve her husband, who was the politician. And yet, because of the death of her husband in 1983, she started to become more involved. And I think that is also a journey of conversion. And after 3 years, no, despite her reluctance, she agreed to become the standard bearer of the opposition then in the 1986 snap elections. And I guess when you take a look at her journey from there, all throughout her career as a politician, as president, she tried to restore the democratic institutions of our country. So makikita nyo rin sa kwento at paglalakbay ni Pangulong Cory, yung kanya ring pagbabalik loob o conversion sa misyon na binigay sa kanya ng Diyos, na pinagpatuloy niya ang misyon ng kanyang asawa at naging sarili niyang misyon. No? Kaya ito isang, siguro almost kagaya nga ng sinasabi ko sa mga tao dati, almost like prophetic. Ano? Pinanganak siya sa kapistahan ng conversion ni San Pablo at siya mismo ay dumaan sa ganung napakalalim na karanasan. Ano? At naging bunga ito sa pagsasabuhay ng misyon niya, no? Na maibalik ang demokrasya sa Pilipinas. That again, that story and process of conversion. Then the final story of conversion that I would like you to reflect on is our story of conversion. Tayo. That I think that the last year of this pandemic and what we saw all around us, no, here in our country, I think I invite you now to go into a process of reflection and prayer and hopefully to ask for the grace of conversion. The conversion to be more zealous in living out our mission, in sharing in the mission to build God's kingdom in our society. A society that is really, no, plagued by so much suffering of hunger, of lack of jobs, no, and the suffering of majority of our marginalized countrymen. Panalangin natin to. Ito yung huling kwento ng pagbabalik loob na nais kong anyayahan kayong pagnilayan. Ang sarili nating pagbabalik loob. Na sa kalagitnaan ng maraming hamon ng ating lipunan, ay sana magkaroon tayo ng pagbabalik loob at ng transformation sa buhay natin upang higit nating isabuhay ang misyon na itatag ang kaharian ng Diyos sa lipunan natin, sa Pilipinas, sa simbahan natin. And let me end by reading quotes from Pope Francis's the prologue, the introduction of his latest book, and the title of the book, and you know, it's an excellent book. The title of the book is Let Us Dream the Path to a Better Future. And let me read excerpts for our reflection. I quote, "I see this time as a reckoning. I think of what Jesus tells Peter in Luke 22, verse 31, that the devil wants him to be sifted like wheat. To enter into crisis is to be sifted. Your categories and ways of thinking get shaken up. Your priorities and lifestyles are challenged. You cross a threshold, either by your own choice or by necessity, because there are crises, like the one we are going through, that you cannot avoid. The question is whether you're going to come out through this crisis, and if so, how? The basic rule of a crisis is that you don't come out of it the same. If you get through it, you come out better or worse, but never the same. When the Lord told us to go forth and multiply, to master the earth, He's saying, be the creators of your future. From this crisis, we can come out better or worse. We can slide back or we can create something new. For now, what we need is the chance to change, to make space for the new thing we need. Hearts have been tested. The crisis has called forth in some a new courage and compassion. Some have been sifted and have responded with a desire to reimagine our world. Others have come to the aid of those in need in concrete ways that can transform our neighbor's suffering. That fills me with hope that we might come out of this crisis better. But we have to see clearly, choose well, and act right." And I pray yun yung ating maging conversion, ang ating pagbabalik loob, yung sinabi ng Santo Papa, that we have to see clearly, choose well, and act right. Makita natin ang biyaya at ang espiritu ng Panginoon sa nangyayari sa atin. At tayo ay pumili ng mabuti kung ano ang ating gagawin. At yung panghuli, nasabi ko nga, bunga ng conversion ay kumilos ng tama upang matulungan ang mga nagdurusa upang makapagtatag ng kaharian ng Diyos sa ating lipunan. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Let us pray for the mission of the Church and the needs of the world redeemed by Christ. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let the Pope, the bishops, and priests may be zealous in preaching repentance and conversion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That missionaries may have the courage to proclaim the gospel even in difficult places and circumstances. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are in doubt or despair may discover the eternal truth which is Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the elderly, the lonely, and the sick may receive the comfort of God's love in their distress. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may be forgiven of their sins and encounter God in His kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us remember in our prayers President Cory on her birth anniversary, that the Lord may grant her eternal rest together with her husband Ninoy, and that she may continue to pray for us, for our people and our country. For this let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of our Redeemer, as we write our prayers with the intercession of St. Paul, deepen the grace of conversion in our lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we celebrate the divine mysteries, O Lord, we pray, may the Spirit fill us with the light of faith, with which He constantly enlightened the blessed Apostle Paul, for the spreading of your glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for all ages and ending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. He gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially today our sister Corazon. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph her spouse, with Saint Paul, with apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
Almighty, ever-living God, source of all mercy and compassion, we come to you in these times of dire need and tremendous suffering. The lives of your people are beset by grave tribulation brought about by the COVID-19. We ask now to look upon us with love, and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death. Restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in this fight for survival. doctors, nurses, hospital staff, and personnel who have themselves fallen under the weight of their immense duties and responsibilities in serving those who are infected with the disease. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease, and for those who have succumbed to the sickness, eternal life in your heavenly kingdom. We pray for workers who tirelessly serve the needs of the people, those in authority in keeping peace and security, and those responsible in leading us to defeat this terrible scourge. Keep them strong and constant in their commitment in the midst of this difficult battle. We pray for those who have been infected by this virus, the dying and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their suffering be their participation in the suffering of your Son. We thank you now for two effective vaccines launched recently and the powerful therapeutics now also on deck. Things have become possible only by your guiding hands. We pray for continuing health and safety of the people, particularly the frontliners leading our crusade against the COVID-19 pandemic, and complete recovery of the victims of this malady. We pray that we will be completely well and will be restored to our normal lives. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us the fire of charity with which the blessed Apostle Paul burned ardently as he bore his concern for all the churches. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.